Oh snap, YouTube, what is going on today? I hope you guys are having another good day. It's been a minute. It feels like it's been a minute, but it's only been a week since I put a video out for you guys, and I feel like I've been away from you guys for a long time. It's been actually a little over a week. Today's Wednesday, last video was last Sunday. Couple things real quick. First things first, I apologize for not uploading as frequently as I would like to. I recently took up, and I'm like halfway in the season right now, but I recently took up deer hunting and duck hunting and stuff. I've had friends show me, and you know, I've always wanted to do it, but never knew how to or where to start at or anything. And I've had people you know, giving me tips, and I've been watching YouTube videos and researching. And you know, I went deer hunting last Saturday for the first time ever. I was in a tree climber, and I got up in a tree probably like 20 feet, and I was just chilling. So it was a good time, you know. Now the reason why I did the walk around of the Cummins, and shout out to the whistle, by the way, it's about 38 degrees out here, so it feels real good. I got a hoodie on, you know what I'm saying? So the reason why I did the walk around is because I wanted to show you how filthy the truck is, and she is disgusting right now. Like, she does not look good, and she's nasty. I haven't had her this dirty in a long time. So this happened yesterday evening when I got off work. I went scouting at this one spot, because where I work at, you can hunt on base. There's hunting spots on base, different locations. So I went scouting yesterday to one spot where it was off road. Didn't really like it, so I ended up leaving, but I just wanted to check it out to see what it looked like. So yesterday she got filthy, covered in dirt, just caked up, everything just nasty. So I'm gonna wash her up, and then I'm gonna get her cleaned up, get her looking right, because I cannot let this stuff sit in the paint, because it's gonna drive me crazy. Get her clean, and then we're gonna go ahead and kick this video off and start talking about what this video is about, which is the fifth gen Cummins. Okay, so y'all stand by, and I'll see y'all in a second. Just real quick, if anybody, if my hunters out there, this is the tree climber I'm using. Got it from Dick's on Black Friday for 150 bucks. Usually it's 200, so I got a pretty good deal on it. And I got some waders over there for when I go in the water and stuff. But yeah, this is what's been occupying my time. All right, let's get started. Alright you guys, so I finished washing the truck. I did a little something extra to it. I'm not gonna say what I did to it, because guess what, I just filmed two videos right now. Like, this is one video right now, you hear me talking, and I just finished the other video. So you guys are gonna have to wait till tomorrow to see that video. But for today's topic, we are gonna hit up the conversation of the new up-and-coming fifth gen Cummins. Okay, as you guys know, it is set to release sometime next summer. It will be the 2020 Ram 2500. So I wanted to talk about that. I have some pictures I found online that I thought, you know, it'd be an interesting conversation for us to have on YouTube.
All right, you guys, hopefully you can hear me good enough, but I had to sit down for this one because I don't feel like we're not gonna be talking for long, but at the same time, I feel like me standing isn't gonna be good enough for this video. So, the 5th Gen Ram is coming soon. We finally saw uncovered pictures of it. I've seen previous pictures of it when it was fully covered. I think, personally, right off the bat, I like it. I like the truck. I think it looks good. Dodge and Ram, they did an excellent job. Chrysler, just period, okay? The 4th Gen Cummins, by far, this is all opinion. This is my opinion. This is how I feel. I want your guys' input and how you feel. But the 4th Gen Cummins is, to me, the best looking Cummins that has been made so far out of all the generations. Hey, I'm just being real. I think the 4th Gen looks better than the 3rd Gens, personally. Yeah, I know I own the 3rd Gen, but that's just my opinion. You know, when Dodge came out with the 4th Gen, it was a hot truck. I mean, they got Truck of the Year back in 20, what was it, like 2010, I believe. They got Truck of the Year. They were back-to-back, actually. I think it was 2009 and 2010. Correct me if I'm wrong, somebody. But I'm pretty sure they got back-to-back Truck of the Year. Dodge has been known for being they kind of veer off and do their own thing. You know, they're known for being a trendsetter, if that makes sense. Going back to the second-gen Dodges when they came out, they got Truck of the Year. Third gen, when they came out, they got Truck of the Year. Every time Dodge is renewed and made something new, then they have gotten Truck of the Year. Dodge was also the first truck to put so back, you know how you can get half cabs back in the day? They were the first ones. They were the first ones to put a half cab door that could swing open. All before then, it was just you had to pull the front seat up and get in it. That was back in like 94, you know. And then when they redesigned the Ram back in the early 2000s for the third gen, they introduced for the V8 gas models, they introduced the Hemi again. Now, that's a whole other debate whether it's a true Hemi like how it was back in the day. But nonetheless, they're innovative. They know how to get their fans, okay? Mopar is also good with it, too. I think I like it. You guys will see the pictures while we're talking. The front end, and what they did was they stuck with the fourth gen. The fourth gen, by no means, okay? The fourth gen came out in, 2010, okay? It is 2018, and the fourth gen still looks like it can compete with the new 6.7. The new Duramax, not the new 2020 Duramax, but the current Duramax out right now. Like, when you line all three of them up, it looks like it belongs there, okay? And you couldn't have said the same thing about the Duramaxes and about the Power Strokes back then. You couldn't have said that back in 2010 when they came out, okay? If you get a 2010 Power Stroke, 2010 Duramax, and you pull it up to the new versions today, they don't go with each other. But the fourth gen, it went with those, and it can still keep up, in my opinion, with the ones that are currently out, okay? It's a good design. And then when you're looking at the pictures, you can tell that they kept the overall shape of it. The ass end looks the same. They did modify the taillights a little bit. The taillights seem to look a little smaller. I don't know if it's just from the picture or if it really is, but they do look a little smaller. Now, the biggest change on this truck so far, this is all aesthetics, though. I have no information, and if it's windy right now, I apologize. I have no information, and I have no readings on what engine, what they're going to do in terms of the diesel engine. We all know that the inline six Cummins is coming back. It probably will have more power, but as far as anything else other than that, no idea. We don't know if the 68 RFE is coming back. We don't know if they're going to bump it up from a 6-speed to maybe an 8-speed or a 10-speed, because apparently the new 2020 Duramax is going to have a 10-speed Allison transmission, which is ridiculous. But hey, that's another debate too, you know. That's also something else too that's been all over the internet lately, is the new updated Duramax is coming out in the 2020s, and they look ugly. I'm going to be real as hell with you. That front end is hideous. From the side, it looks okay, but from the front, that thing looks like somebody hit it with a jackhammer or like a dead blow mallet. I don't know what they did to it. But anyways, back to the fifth gen Cummins. So the front end definitely did get a change. You can tell that they didn't make it identical to the 1500 front end, which thank God they didn't, because I do love the 1500s, but what they chose to put on the 2500s fits it better, if that makes sense. You guys probably saw the picture already of the Ram 2500, it's the Rebel. That one looks nice. I'm pretty sure that's only in the V8 model, the Hemi, 6.4 Hemi. Hopefully, if they brought, I don't know why they don't make it's not the Rebel, it's the Power Wagon, I believe. The Power Wagon. I don't know why they won't put a Cummins in the Power Wagon. I personally think the Power Wagon is a nice looking vehicle. To me, that type of truck is the type of truck where if I lived on a farm, or if I did a lot of dirt road driving, just not always on the streets, and I didn't want to worry about chipping my bumper paint and all that stuff, I would definitely get a Power Wagon, because it's already equipped. I mean, it has the right tires, it has a good, the way they did the body, everything was good. I would love to see a Cummins in a Power Wagon. That'd be amazing. And also the Rebel too. So I think that Cummins is good. I think the fifth gen Cummins is a pretty truck. I like it, because the reason why I think it's pretty is because they stuck with the overall basis of the fourth gen exterior. They just tweaked it, okay? They weren't trying to reinvent the wheel. They were just trying to make it spin better. You know what I'm saying? Which is, I like that. Sometimes companies and car manufacturers are known for this. They try too hard. And you can tell when a car manufacturer tries too hard to make something good. They mean well, and they want the best out of the vehicle, but they try too hard. Chrysler, when they did this, they did not try too hard. They didn't try hard enough. They did it just right, in my personal opinion. I think it's a good-looking truck. I can't wait to start seeing Instagram pictures of people, you know, modeling the trucks and building them up, you know, lift kits and rims. I can't wait to start seeing pictures like that, because I honestly would think, I honestly believe that that is going to be a powerful, pretty-looking truck. You know what I'm saying? And this is all, once again, this is all opinion-based. So, you know, I got a third gen. I have no intentions of getting a fifth gen anytime soon, because my pockets cannot afford anything like that right now. Maybe down the road once they've been out for years. But I'm sticking with the old third gen mega cab. So, you know, it's all good. But absolutely, you know, I think it's good. I like it, you know. You guys, please let me know what you think about the vehicle, about the Cummins. Tell me if you like the pictures I found. If I'm sure most of you already have seen the pictures, but I figure we can talk about it and just, you know, I can give you guys my opinion on it, you know, because us truck enthusiasts and diesel enthusiasts, you know, we're always like judging and being critical and all that stuff, you know, nitpicking and whatnot. And, you know, you can call me a Dodge, Cummins fanboy, whatever. The Power Strokes are beautiful looking trucks. The new redesigned 6.7s, I think, are beautiful trucks. But I think that the Ram, the new 2020s, are a little bit better, in my personal opinion. And it's not me being a fan board, no, it's just me saying what I think looks good. And you guys got to remember, you know, before you jump on a comment board and be like, you know, yada, 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 this is all opinion-based. I want to hear your opinion, but, you know, also make it constructive. Don't just be like, it's ugly, you know. Why is it ugly? You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it adult-like in the comment section. But I definitely like it, and I don't know, I mean, hopefully we can see more in terms of the interior. I couldn't find interior pics, and I haven't found a whole lot on the engine specs and lucky stuff like that. From what I've read, I did read one bullet where it said that the interior would be very similar to the new 1500s that are currently out. I don't know if you guys have seen the interiors on the new 1500s, but those things, it's like a hotel in there. That thing is ridiculous. It's like a 5-star. It's like a Marriott or a Hilton. It's beautiful. And I feel feel warm and happy, like you're living in like a little cabin when you're inside the cab. So what I plan on doing is, when the dealership where I live at gets the new 2020s, they say it can be till like next summer. When they get the new 2020 Cummins, I do intend on it. Would like to go and make a video on it, doing a walk around and seeing what's new about the truck. Obviously with their permission if they allow me to, but I would love to do that. Let me know how you guys feel about that feedback. I know there's other car channels that they get first dibs and they have an inside connection to when, you know, they can record the new vehicles that are out before, like, most of the dealerships get them. So, but for our channel, you know, our community, our family, let me know if you like that, all right? It is, like, 38 degrees out here and it's windy. I'm annoyed. So we're going to go ahead and wrap this video up, and I will see you guys tomorrow. All right, you guys, that's going to do it for today's video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Once again, please comment down below and let me know what you think. Also, let me know how you feel about me making a video on the new 5th-gen Cummins, if I can find them, okay? Once again, I don't have any plans on buying one. Oh, let me get zoom out real quick. I don't have any plans on buying one, but I do have plans on wanting to get one on camera, okay? You know, somebody that might have one, might be able to get one on video, and they're near me, let me know. Shoot me that DM. Like always, please like this video. It really helps out the channel grow, helps the video get recognized by new YouTubers. The channel's been growing constantly. Thank you guys for us hitting 4,000 subscribers. It happened really quick, and I'm really grateful for it, and I really appreciate it, okay? So until next time, which is going to be tomorrow, make sure y'all tune into tomorrow's video, because I will have back-to-back videos, this video tonight, and then the next video tomorrow. So until then, y'all take it easy, be safe, peace out.